Hey guys, so welcome to this new video. So I was thinking, and with Taylor Swift re-recording all her albums and the first one being Fearless, I thought it would be fun to kind of sit down and pull out all of my old Fearless merch and kind of go through it and reminisce and show you guys, if you guys obviously didn't understand what I was talking about there. So Taylor Swift is now re-recording and releasing all of her old albums, and she is starting off with Fearless. You can actually go listen to Love Story, Taylor's version, right now. I highly suggest you do, but since she is starting out with Fearless, I thought I would go through all of my Fearless specific merch. I have been a fan since 2007, so I do have quite a bit of merchandise. So yeah, we're gonna go through all my Fearless stuff, even though I'm wearing a Speak Now tour shirt, but that's okay. Where to start? I have a cabinet in my room with like all my Taylor stuff, and yeah, I think the first place to start. So on this cabinet, I have this poster, and it's from the Fearless tour in 2009. I went to that one and the one in 2010, and this they were giving out. I saw her at Madison Square Garden and they were just like handing these out, and so of course I grabbed one and I have it in my little cabinet over here. Okay, so we're just gonna pull stuff out. This is gonna be a long one. So I guess the first one I can pull out is this book. I mean, it has like pictures. It's all pretty much from the Fearless tour. And then I have this book, Taylor Swift Love Story. I feel like so many people have this book, but again, it's like another one of those like all about Taylor books. Have I read this in a long time? No, I don't even think I actually fully read it when I got it. I think I just flipped through the pictures and added it to my collection. And then of course we had the Fearless songbook for guitar. So I started playing guitar the summer of 2008, so I had like just become a Taylor fan and I started playing guitar, and actually one of my first things of merch was actually the debut one. Okay, so let's move on. So I have this little like drawer thing, and in it I have all my tour books. So I have me Fearless tour book. The Fearless tour originally was in 2009, and then it was so popular that she extended it and did a second leg. I went to both, and so I ended up getting this at the second leg because I decided I wanted it afterwards. And so I got it at my second show. And also I have a shit ton of posters that I really don't want to get out and unroll, but I do have this as a poster, and I have her first Rolling Stone cover, which I have the actual magazine of, but I have that as a poster as well. Holy shit, I have this like this little like teeny tiny book. So okay, I have a very long story, but we're gonna keep it short. So I had one of the Fearless boxes. My dumbass, of course, got the Taylor Swift Coke bottles, and I had two thing like cases of them. So I had one that was, I drank all of them, and then I had another one that was completely closed. And me being an idiot had them in my little cabinet, and the one that was full exploded, and it ruined I had to throw away a bunch of magazines. It ruined the box. The box got moldy. That's pretty much the only thing it ruined. Luckily, everything inside, if I remember correctly, was pretty much fine. I just had to throw the box away. But yeah, I had to throw away a bunch of magazines. It literally molded a shelf in the cabinet. So I had that, but I have the stuff that was inside of it. And one of them was this photo album, and it had like these cards, TaylorNation.com. Oh my God. And then I just put just some pictures from like release weeks and stuff, and more little, some pictures from concerts. But like this came in the Fearless box, and it came with the CD, which yeah, so I have like three copies of Fearless, but this is like one of the only things left from my Fearless box. RIP. Also, another kind of long story, but I have this still. So this is a project that I did my freshman year of high school, which I was a freshman, 2008-2009, Fearless era. And we read Romeo and Juliet for my English class. And so we had to make, my teacher was very like creative and fun, and so we had to make these little books about Romeo and Juliet. I added a ton of Taylor pictures from like the Love Story video. Inside there's like Taylor quotes and more pictures and stuff. And I got an A on it, and my teacher said she loved the Taylor Swift touch. Okay, so now we have accessories and stuff. So I have this Fearless bracelet. I didn't actually buy this. I think I got this as like a free gift. It is so freaking old in here. Okay, nope, this is all Reputation. My God, I have a lot of shit. I have this other Fearless bracelet, one of the wrap around ones, but I never actually wore it because the leather is very cheap. Because I also have this one, the like OG love 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 bracelet from her shop, like the same one that she's doing the video of. The leather is so much much nicer. It's not leather, obviously. I do have this one, which is like the new style that they ended up selling. Okay, so now we're gonna move on to clothing. These are like 50% of my Taylor shirts, and I have them folded up and shoved in there. Literally, this is probably my favorite Taylor shirt ever. I wore this almost every day. My Fearless Tour shirt. I got this one, and this is the back, and this one is actually from my first show. And then I have this other tour shirt, and this one I got in my second show because I liked both, but then I decided at the first show I got that one, and then because I went again I was like, I'll get this one this time. We got another one, so I can't believe I still have this. It does not fit me anymore. I just keep it for sentimental reasons. But I have this LEI dress that I got at Walmart when she did the like collab. I also have, this is like a blur in my mind, so I can't remember if this is Fearless or Speak Now, but I have the I Knit Sweaters Yo t-shirt. I'm pretty sure this is Speak Now, but we're gonna add it in here. But I have this. So I have one more shirt that is not a shirt anymore. This shirt is also from LEI. It didn't fit me anymore, so I had my grandmother make a low of it. This, but I have this shirt as well. Now we have some more accessories, I guess you can call them. I've never worn them as accessories, but basically they're pins. So these pins were all at Justice. My god, I feel like I'm showing my age right now. I have, and these again are a mix of Fearless and Debut. Technically they all came out during Fearless era. We have this one. Okay, so next we have one Fearless related DVD, and that is Journey to Fearless. And fun fact, I bought this when I went to Nashville for the first time in 2012. I have this Keds box. I'm not sure what's in it. We're also discovering that I have a lot of shit with Taylor's name on it. This is what happens when you're a fan of someone for like 14 years. Oh, here it is. Okay, this was in the Taylor box, and it's like a mosaic of fan photos. Oh, and this was also in the box. Okay, so this, it was in a scrapbook, so I know it has glitter all over it. But this was my ticket for my first Taylor show, August 27th, 2009. So first time I saw Taylor. So that's it, Fearless Tour at number one. And then this is from, this was the second Fearless Tour I went to. Oh my god, so many memories. And then this, another like flyer they were handing out. So oh, this was, okay, so this was also in the box, and there was like a ticket to win like the Ultimate Taylor Experience. I think you go to tour, like you got to like get tickets to the tour and meet her and stuff. I did not win. Oh, here's some little LEI things. So now we're gonna do CDs. So of course I have the original copy of Fearless that I bought the day it came out, and then I also have the Platinum Edition. Again, bought this whenever it came out, and I have this unopened copy of Fearless. So I also have a bunch of magazines. I really don't want to go through them, but I don't remember what's left from Fearless and what I had to throw away, but I have a lot. So that is pretty much all or most of my Fearless merch. I can't remember if there's like anything else lying around. That's pretty much it. I thought I had more than I did, but I also was a high schooler and didn't have my own money and buy a lot back then. So yeah, that's pretty much everything I have, and I can't wait to keep doing these and like keep reminiscing as the other albums come out, specifically like the older ones, just because it's just fun to go back and reminisce about like that time in your life. It's also going to be easier to do because I have significantly less merch from pretty much like the first three albums than I do of like Red and On. That's pretty much all of my Fearless merch. If you liked this video, give it a big thumbs up. Leave a comment down below and let me know if you have any merch from Fearless era, or if you are excited to get merch from the new Fearless era, I guess you can call it. But that's about it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching.